Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to another problem. This is an Angular Intermediate for the HackerRank certification. So this problem is very simple. Okay. So we'll just go through the problem statement and then we'll start writing the code. Okay. So this is Angular, and when you are typing some city, we are looking into some API call or maybe some mock data. And here we can see there are three different views. Weather data, no result found, and this text field, which is doing the ng model binding, and there is a ng model change event we will be triggering that will look for this string inside some data and it will populate this on the UI. Okay, so functionality requirement, we have the array of objects, like we already have mock data of temperature and the name of the city. There is input text fields, and these are the IDs which you are not going to change. If there is a no data exist, then no result found. If there is a data exist, then you need to populate temperature, wind, humidity in these respective locations. Okay, because the test cases are dependent on these. Okay, so this is a specification. Let's write this. So we have this app component. Inside app component, we can see there is some mock data. This is the weather data. City is temperature, wind, humidity. This data we have. We are passing this data in our component using the same input binding, weather data, and now we are in the weather detail component. Inside weather detail component, using input binding, we got this data. Okay, and now we can play with this data based on the event we are doing. So in the weather detail, this is our input text field, right? Here we have ng model. City and ng model change. Whenever you are typing something in this ng model, we are calling this city change method, and we already know we don't need to make an API call. We already have a mock data, weather data. We just need to do a filter and need to find city exist in there or not. Simple logic, should be simple, I think. So here we can write one method, city change. Inside city change, we will decide like what the value you are passing. So it should be the same logic I think we have written in the last video. If somebody is entering the city value, then if value is not null, then what we will say is let found city, and we are going to do the filter. This dot weather data which we have received using input binding. So we do access that dot find, because we need to find a single city, and it will just return a single object from the array. So from each and every city, we just wanted to check city dot name, and we can do a two lowercase because we need to do a comparison, and we'll convert both into lowercase. And we, here we have value dot to lowercase. Always keep that in mind whenever you are doing a comparison of whatever you are entering in the text field and whatever is there in the data. Okay, so always convert that into the lowercase. If we are able to found that city, if the city is found, that means we got the data. So we will just have a one city details, this variable. This will just put the city detail of current selected city. And then we just need to toggle some fields, like we need to show now the weather data, right? So this dot hide details. Hide details true. This dot show no result is false, because now we have a result, we can show it. If there is no city found, then that means we have to show no data found. Hide details false and show no result true. And if there is no value, I mean there is no value, then we will just do if else, because we need to pass all the test cases. This dot show no result, this will become false. Both will become false in that case if there is no value inside the text field. This is a simple logic, right? City change, we found the city using dot find. Now we just toggle, we need to show the weather data. So high details is true, show no result is false because there is a no result div. And now we go to the HTML. And here we are doing, so this is city detail. If city detail is true, then we are going to show all this data, temperature, wind and humidity. If no result found is true, then we will show this div instead of this div. Okay, this is the only difference. One of the div will be available at a time, city detail and high detail. If both are false, then nothing will be shown here from both the div, right? So this is something which is tracked in the test cases. You need to check your show and hide conditions whenever you are doing it. Okay, so that's it. That's the last video about certifications. Rest all videos are about interview preparations, because now companies are sending these kind of assignments. Because even if you are good at Angular and React, sometimes you messed up with these test cases and you're not able to fulfill that. So if you do these 2-3 exercises, you will be good. I mean, you know how to pass the test cases. You can also take a look onto these test cases, what they are talking about. You can see it's nothing but it's also having some weather data. This is the Angular test cases. And it is just passing the values and it is checking these divs are available or not. Whenever you are entering some value, when you are entering empty value, when you are entering the wrong city which is not there, all these test cases are there. Like whenever you are entering a correct city like Dallas, then all these things should be there and no results should be false, right? When you are passing Seattle, that means it's not there, you should get no result found, right? Weather details should be falsy, all these things. Okay, that's all. Thanks everyone.